An alternative to using list comprehensions is to use higher order sequence functions. And these have been in programming languages for a long time and are fundamental operations on sequences that everybody should know. So, they're kind of like functions that perform list comprehensions for you, using the higher order machinery we've already seen. So one of them is called apply to all, which takes some function and some sequence and applies that function to each element of the sequence. And here we see a simple implementation, which is just to use a list comprehension to apply that function to each x in S. So what happens here? Well, let's say I have a function that multiplies things by 3 or triples things. Then if I apply to all the function that triples things to the range 5, which includes 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4, tripling all those will give me 0, 3, 6, 9, 12. So apply to all takes in one sequence, applies some function to each element, and gives you back another sequence. KeepIf is another higher order function that does sequence manipulation. And it gives you back a list of all the elements of S for which some function evaluates to true when called on that element. And the simplest way to implement this KeepIf higher order function is using a list comprehension that doesn't do any transformation of the elements, but filters them using the filter function. So you're only going to keep x in S if filter from x is a true value. So again, if I have a function, say the function that returns true if x is greater than 5, and then I keep all of the elements in the range 10, if this function is true for that element, I'll be left with 6, 7, 8, and 9. And I've lost 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So in this case, I had a range from 0 to 9. Here I've written it out as a list, but it really was a range in the first place, which was slightly different, but they contain the same elements. I filtered it, and I was left with a list, 6, 7, 8, 9. So when you apply to all, you get the same number of different elements, and when you keep if, you get the smaller number of the same elements. Let's look at another sequence operation, reducing a sequence to a single value. The idea is to combine the elements of some sequence S pairwise, so two at a time, using some reduce function, starting with an initial value. Let's look at an example to understand what that means. If I reduce using the mul function, the sequence 2, 4, 8, starting with an initial value of 1, that's the same as if I multiplied 1, the initial value, times the 0th element, and then took that result and multiplied it by the element at index 1, and took that result and multiplied it by the element at index 2, marching through the sequence in order. So actually calling reduce on this expression will give me 64, which is 1 times 2 times 4 times 8. Okay, let's look at an implementation. We're going to start out by saying the reduced value is just the initial value. And then, for every element, x and s, I'm going to rebind reduced to be whatever I get by calling the reduce function on whatever I've reduced so far, and x, the next element in the sequence, and then return reduced. So what are the inputs to this function? We have a two-argument function, that's why reduce is higher order. We have s, which is a sequence of values, and each of these values will eventually be passed as the second argument to the reduce function. And we have initial, which is a value that is passed in as the first argument to the reduce function. And the expression tree that's built up is many-layered, one layer for each element in the sequence. So let's look at another example. I want to reduce using pow, which raises one number to the power of another, the sequence 1, 2, 3, 4. So these are all going to be the second arguments to pow. So these are going to be the things that I raise something to. And 2 will be the base. That's the initial value. So this is like calling pow on 2 and 1, the first element of the sequence that I'm reducing. And what's 2 to the first power? Well, it's just 2. The next thing I do is call pow on 2 and the next element of the sequence, which raises 2 to the second power, which gives me 4. I call pow again. So I'm always calling the same function over and over again. Now I call it on the reduced value so far, and the next element, 4 to the power of 3 is 64. And finally, I call pow on 64, and the final element, and 64 to the fourth power is 16 million. And I'm done. So let's use a couple of these higher order sequence functions. KeepIf takes a filter function and a sequence, and it returns the same elements that were in the sequence, only fewer of them, by checking to see if the filter function applied to each x returns a true value. Using this, I could rewrite the divisors of n to first define a function that is takes an x and figures out whether x divides n evenly by applying the remainder operator and checking to see if the remainder of dividing n by x is 0. Then I return 1, which divides everything, plus the result of calling keepIf on divides n over the entire range of 2 up to, but not including n. So if I want to know the divisors of 6, I'll get 1, 2, and 3. Of 8, I'll get 1, 2, and 4. And 24 has a lot of divisors. Next, let's look at reduce, which takes a reduce function, some sequence, and some initial value. It computes a single reduced value, which will be returned, which starts off as the initial value. And then for every element x in S, I'm going to rebind reduced to what I get whenever I call the reduce function on our current reduced value and this next element x of S. So one interesting property to explore of integers is what happens when you sum their divisors. So if I want to sum up all the divisors of n, I would do that by reducing, using the add function, all of the divisors of n, starting out with a sum of 0. So the sum of the divisors of 24 is actually 36, which is just the sum of all these numbers together. Don't believe me? We can do it like this as well, with a little copy and paste. Okay, and the sum of the divisors of 9 is 4. So we can see that sometimes the sum of the divisors is bigger than the number that I passed in originally, and sometimes it's smaller. And sometimes it's exactly the number that I passed in. So this says the sum of all the divisors of 6 happens to be 6. That's nice. In fact, that's not just called nice in mathematics. That's called a perfect number. A perfect number is one where the sum of the divisors of n is equal to n. Once I've defined perfect in this way, I could use keepIf. I only want the perfect ones of all the numbers up to 1,000. And we've just computed that the only perfect numbers less than 1,000 are 6, the one we found, 28, which has divisors 1, 2, 4, 7, and 14, and finally 496. So now we've learned something about higher order sequence functions. I should admit to you that the names I just used aren't the typical names that are used in most programming languages. Apply to all is usually called map. Now, unfortunately, map means lots of different things, both in the world and in computer science, so that's why I'll call it apply to all. So you know that it's some function that applies another function to all the elements in a sequence. And keepif is usually called filter, which is a pretty good name. Reduce is typically called reduce, but goes by many other names, called fold and accumulate and several others. So be careful that while these general concepts of applying to all or keeping only a subset or reducing are ubiquitous in computing, they can come in many different names. In fact, map and filter are built-in functions in Python. And they do the same thing that I told you, but they don't return lists. They return something else. Iterable values, yes, but lists, no. And the problem with it is that it's hard to see what exactly you got back. So that's why we've defined our own. And reduce is actually part of Python as well, but it's not built in. It's part of the standard library, and so you have to import it from a module called functools. Okay, so now you know the names that everyone else uses, map, filter, and reduce. Most Python programmers just use list comprehensions when they can. But it is possible to use these higher order sequence functions in order to manipulate sequences as well.